welcome to the Tonight Show. And
man, thank you for having me. It's my first time on a talk show, man. This is great.
I love that.
I love the selection, too.
That's a good selection. Yeah, of course. You can't mess with the roots, man. Absolutely. Now, I want to know, tell us about yourself, because this is your acting debut as well, right?
So, interestingly enough, I never aspired to be an actor at all. It kind of just came, like, my best friend who's here with me, he's in the backstage. He's like, dude, you got to do this audition, you know what I'm saying, the casting call for Tupac. You got to do that, and, you know.
But where were you at the time? What were you doing?
I was just working, just regular jobs, you know, trying to make a living. I always wanted to be a music producer.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, working on that and then just doing my regular job.
What were your regular jobs?
Target, you know, that's what I was trying to start. Shout out to Target for the job.
Absolutely.
Sam's Club, Sears.
That's great. And did anyone ever tell you that you look like Tupac?
Yeah, so that started, like, in, like, high school, you know. I went to high school, and, like, in 10th grade, I was kicking it with, like, the seniors. I introduced myself, and it was like, yeah, Demetrius is cool, but we're going to call you Pac. That was it.
And where did you grow up?
Carson, California.
In California, yeah. So you knew
Carson.
So obviously, but that's a cool thing to be look like Tupac. I mean, he's a good-looking dude.
I mean, it could be worse, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. So then you go on this, was it a blind audition? I don't understand.
It was like online, and then he told me to do it or whatever. So I wait till like the last day. I submit the video.
Because you're not an actor. You go, I don't know.
No, yeah. So I really wasn't going to do it. He had to like badger me to do it. I'm like, all right, whatever, I'll do it. And so waited till the last day, turned it in on the, like 30 minutes before the deadline, and then shared it on Facebook. And then my father seen the video. Now, the cool thing about that is my father produced with Tupac. He produced Tupac's Toss It Up single.
Really?
Yeah. He seen that, and he shared the video with L.T. Hutton, the creator and producer of this movie. And from then on, the ball got rolling back in 2011.
2011? Yeah. What year is it now? Like, why? I don't understand. Like, what?
It's 2017.
Thank you. So you waited 6 years? No.
So in between those time, I was, you know, stocking stuff at Target and Sam's Club, ringing people up and, you know, trying to get the role as well. Just trying to, I guess they had to get the stuff together. You know, it's a biopic, so you know how that goes.
Yeah, of course. And what was your audition like? What did you end up doing? Did you have lines or did you?
So one of the things was I had to do this courtroom monologue that Tupac does. It's an interview. He's coming out and he's speaking to the press. So I had to recreate that. And then I had to do, a rap and the whole thing.
Wow. Yeah. I mean, aren't you nervous? Auditioning in front of people, or you just know?
Yeah, that time I went in with the casting director and the actual real director, and I was like, wow, what is going on? Dude?
I mean,
all of these lights, all of these people. You want me to just rap?
Yeah.
Okay, let's make it happen.
Wow, so then you filmed the movie, and now it's coming out, and you're getting already great reviews, and it's a big deal. This is like, this is major. This is the Tupac movie that we've all been waiting for. I know his hits, and I know some of his albums, but I don't really know that much about his life.
You don't know a lot about Tupac, Jimmy?
I know.
You gotta have a verse somewhere. Come on, Jimmy. I know you know a verse.
Oh, no. you're all gonna thank me for not doing that. I followed, I know Keep Your Head Up, and I know all that stuff. But I know Oakland is where he said that he's from, but he's not really from Oakland, right?
Well, he was born in New York, and then he moved to Baltimore, and then he moved to Oakland when he was like a teenager, like 17 years old.
Gosh, and when did he die? How old was he when he died?
25.
Gosh, how sad is that? That just died way too young.
Yeah.
And what are people going to take away from when they see this film?
They're just going to get a great understanding of Tupac. Myself, personally, I was a fan of the music, and I didn't know the man. This is going to give you an insight to the man. You're going to understand all of the rumors and speculations or anything that you don't know. It'll all be clear within this movie.